Did you know that there are signs of prediabetes that show up 5 to 10 years before you're diagnosed? To be officially diagnosed with prediabetes, your fasting blood sugar has to be above 100 milligrams per deciliter or 5.6 millimoles per liter. But what causes prediabetes starts years before your blood sugar reaches this level. If you have any of the 7 signs we're going to talk about in this video, you have the power to stop the progression to type 2 diabetes. And the earlier you catch it, the easier it's going to be to keep your fasting blood sugar at a healthy level and prevent complications in the future. Sign number 1 is high blood pressure. If your doctor has diagnosed you with chronic high blood pressure or hypertension, this alone is a really strong indicator that you're on track to develop prediabetes. Over 50% of hypertension cases are directly caused by insulin resistance. Some evidence even suggests that number could be as high as 90%. And insulin resistance is actually what causes prediabetes as well. Insulin is one of the main hormones that controls our blood sugar. When there's excess sugar in our bloodstream, insulin takes it to the cells in our body to use for energy. However, when our cells start to resist insulin, then we have a problem. The body will produce more insulin in response to the cells not taking in glucose as they should, and this excess insulin is enough to keep our blood sugar levels at a healthy level for a while, but we are left with high insulin as a result. And it's this high insulin that causes the side effects that allow us to predict prediabetes years in advance, one of which being high blood pressure. Number 2 is a high waist to height ratio. If the circumference of your waist is high in relevance to your height, this is another strong indicator that you are on track for prediabetes. So you can take your waist measurement and your height in the same unit, so that can be centimeters or inches, and divide your waist by your height. Anything over 0.53 is a red flag. The reason this simple test is so accurate is that abdominal or visceral fat is one of the most common symptoms of high insulin from insulin resistance. When you're insulin resistant, fat doesn't always get stored as it normally would, and it ends up accumulating around our organs in our midsection instead. Number 3, skin tags. Skin tags, which are different than moles, can develop around our neck, our armpits, and our groin, and these are also a predictor of prediabetes. These tags develop when someone's insulin is high for an extended period of time, because insulin is a growth-stimulating hormone. And this is also the reason that high insulin causes us to gain fat. It stimulates things to grow. Now, there's this misconception that skin tags are caused by friction, and this is absolutely not the case. A lot of people will opt to have their skin tags removed by their doctor, but unfortunately, this is only a band-aid fix. The underlying cause of skin tags, which is high insulin, is still gonna remain. And this means the skin tags are just gonna come back. Number 4, high triglycerides and low HDL cholesterol. The level at which our triglycerides and our HDL is at can also predict prediabetes. The ratio between triglycerides and HDL can tell us a lot about our insulin sensitivity or resistance. To find your ratio, take your triglycerides and your HDL in milligrams per deciliter and divide them. A ratio under 1.9 is considered optimal with good insulin sensitivity and a low risk of developing prediabetes. A ratio between 2 to 3 indicates some insulin resistance and prediabetes potentially in the future. And a ratio over 3 means you're very insulin resistant and you're probably pretty close to prediabetes. Number 5, an irregular menstrual cycle. This one is only for women, of course. But again, this comes back to high levels of insulin, because when insulin levels are high in our body, this causes women to create more male hormones. Side note, the opposite happens for men. High insulin actually causes a decrease in testosterone. But back to women, because of this hormonal imbalance, periods can become irregular. So if you have an irregular cycle, this might be a sign you're on track for prediabetes. Number 6, adult acne. This side effect again stems from the hormonal imbalance we just spoke about. For women, with more male hormones, skin becomes oilier and this can lead to breakouts. And finally, number 7, again, this one is only for women, excess hair growth. And as with the last two, this comes from the increase in testosterone. And this hair growth happens in places that it typically wouldn't for women: on the face, stomach, chest, and back. And a little bit of a side note, but for women with PCOS, of which one of the side effects is excess hair growth. PCOS, the underlying cause, is also insulin resistance, and this is why they respond so well to the prescription drug metformin. This drug improves insulin sensitivity, and 9 out of 10 women with PCOS who take it see a reduction in their symptoms, including this excess hair growth. Now, before I wrap up, I want to quickly tell you about today's sponsor, Squarespace. If you are thinking about building a website for either a business or for personal use, Squarespace has got you covered. Their award-winning customizable templates will give your website a polished and professional look, while also being highly customizable. You have complete control over colors, fonts, sizing, photos, and more. Their templates are beautiful and professional. Not only did I build and do I run my website with Squarespace, but I also manage my email list and design and send out newsletters through Squarespace as well. You can also run your online store and accept payments too. You can head to squarespace.com/healthcoachkate to start your free trial without having to enter your credit card details or anything. And when you build your website and you love it and you're ready to launch, make sure to use code healthcoachkate to save 10% off your order. Thanks again to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. Anyways, guys, that's all I have for you today. Let me know in the comment section down below how many of these signs you have and if you already knew that they were related to prediabetes. If you weren't aware, has this been a little bit of a wake-up call? Are there any changes you're gonna make now that you know this? Let me know down below. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.